In this video, we are going to create this expanding cards widget, which can be used for different occasions based on how you want it. So this is taken from the 50 products in 50 days course by Brad Travisi of Travisi Media. So the code for this is given in the GitHub repo. Do check that out. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. So guys, like we discussed in the last video, we are using the template that we created last day, and we have just copied the template over, and we have used live server to run, and it's running on port 5500, and it's open our browser. So whatever changes we do here, it will be reflected here. So let's begin by removing the h1 tag here, and we want the whole content, the whole card, to be in a class name container. So we'll create a div with a class name of container. Then in that container, there will be other class with the class name panel, and this active class will be the one that will be deciding if the card is open or not. So this panel class will be common for all panels, and this active class will determine if the class is active or not. And for this panel class, we'll add a background image, and that will be the image of that is there for the card. So it will be a URL that is referring to an unsplash image. So I have collected 5 unsplash images for the sale. So we'll just use that. So paste it here. So now we can see this image is here, and we'll add an H3 tag that says the say something. So for in this case, it's explore the world. So when we do that and save, you can see some image this has happened, and a background image is applied. So we'll do the same with others also. We'll create 5 such tags. So we have created 5 such tags, and when we save it, we can see that 5 different H3 tags with the background image of the image that we have given here has been formed here. So that's all there is in the HTML tag. Now we'll change the style.css file. So in here, we'll at first change the flex direction. So we don't want that. We would like to change the font. We don't want Roboto font here. We want a Malay font. Then we change the font family as well, and save that. The font has been changed. So now we'll apply some styling to the container. We'll apply the apply display flex, and when we save that, all the elements have been arranged in a row. So at present, it is taking 100% of the width, so we don't want that. So we'll change the width to say 90% of viewport width. So when we save that, it takes only 90% of the viewport width. So that's all we need for the container. Now coming to the panel. So in the panel styling, we want the background image size to be to cover the panel, and so we'll set the border position to center. Then we don't want the background image to repeat, so background repeat to no repeat, Then we'll set the height of the panel as 80% of the viewport height. So when we save it, you can see that it's taken 80% of the viewport height. And we want a border radius. So border radius we want of 50 pixel. And when we save that, you can see a border radius has been applied. Then we want a flex. Since it's a flex box, we can apply an amount of flex. So if we apply 0.5 flex, you can see it's uniform throughout now. We'll set the position of the panel as relative, because we want the H3 tag, which is this these words, to be absolute, and we want it to be beneath. So we are setting the position to be relative in the panel itself. Now, when the transition takes place from active to not active, we want an effect to happen. So we don't want it to be sudden. So we'll set a transition on the flex parameter for say 0.5 second, and we want it to ease in. So let's save that. Now we'll change the text color. So we'll set color as white. Now when we hover over all these things, it's showing a different cursor, so we'll set a cursor for that. So we'll set cursor as pointer. That's it, I guess. Now coming to the H3 tag inside the panel. So we want the position of the H3 tag to be absolute, and we want it on the bottom left portion. So we'll set a bottom left as 20 pixel each. So when we'll do that and save, the position has been changed to bottom left. Okay, we want a margin for the panel as well, since it's together. We want a margin of 10 pixel, say. So there is a bit gap between the panels. When the panel is active, we want the flex to be of a particular amount. So for example, so when the panel is active, it will show it takes a bigger picture, while the other is shrunk down. So also when the panel by default, when the panel is shrunk down, we don't want the text to be there, so we'll set the opacity of the text to be 0. And when the panel is active, we want the text to be active. So panel dot active and H3 tag within that, we want the opacity to be 1. So now the text is visible only in the panel where the active class is there. So for say for smaller screen, we don't want to show all 5, because it will get very crammed in. So say if we want to remove the we want to show only the only 3 panels when the screen size is small, for that we'll write a media query. So at media, and we'll there are different parameters that we can pass here, say max width or minimum width. So we'll give a parameter of max width, and give it a value of 480 pixel. So when the screen size screen width is less than 480 pixel, this CSS will be present. So when the to do that, let's just open the developer tools and reduce the screen size to a mobile screen. So in this case, it's less than 480 pixel. So in this case, we don't want the container to take 80%. Instead, we want it to take the whole width. So we'll set the width as 100 viewport width. And so there is a bit more room here. Then what we'll do is we'll remove those additional panels. So we don't want the fourth and the fifth panel. So we'll use a pseudo selector, which is nth of type. And when we say fourth, this fourth panel will be selected, and we'll just copy it once more here. And when we type five, the fifth panel will be selected. And for the smaller scale, smaller screen size, we'll set the display to none. So when the screen size is small, you can see now there is only three panels are available. But when the screen size goes beyond 480 pixel, five panels are available. So this is because of this media query that we have written. So now let's just let's add the click or the transition feature which happens when we click on the panel. So to do that, we'll open a script.js file. There are different ways of doing it, but we'll use query selector to do here. So what we'll do is we'll select all the classes with the class name of panel, and then we'll remove and add active classes to change the width of the image here. So to do that, we'll first select all the div with the class of panel. So for that, we'll use document dot query selector all. So with this function, we can select all the classes or IDs or tags that are present in the HTML file. So for now, what we'll do is we'll select the class named panel, and when this code is run, we'll get a list of elements which has the class name of panels. So like an array, this is a node list, by the way. Like the array, we can loop through it to get each panel. So we want some action to take place when each of the panels is clicked. So for that, we'll use an array function which is for each, and we'll loop through each of the HTML tag. And for each of them, what we'll do is we'll add an onClick listener. So for that, we'll do panel dot add event listener, and we want the event to be a click listener. And when the click happens, we want this function to be called. So when this panel is clicked, this function will be called, and the code written here will be executed. So what we want is we want to add a class called active in the class list of panel. So what we'll do is we'll take that panel, and we have a function called class list, and we'll add a class called active. So when we do that, all the panels are here, and when we click something, a panel is added. and it's going like this. So why is this like this? Because we do not remove the active class when something else is active. So what we want to do is when we click on something, we want to remove the previous classes which has the active. So what we'll do is when the click happens, we'll call a function called remove active class, and we'll write that function here. So remove active classes, and in this function, what we want is we want to loop through each of the panel, and we want to remove the class list from active from each of the panel. So from each of the panel, we want to remove panel dot class list dot remove the class active. So when you do that, now when we click here, nothing happens. That's because it's not panel, it's panels. So when we do that change and save, now we can see that it's there, but the transition is not uniform. So what we'll do is we'll go to style.css and go to the transition in here. Okay, so the issue was we didn't put the time seconds here. So now when we toggle the active, so you can see this takes a 0.5 second to transition to the next state. So now you can see that when we click, the text is directly active and it's a different. So we'll add a transition to the h3 tag as well. So here we'll add a transition of opacity for a duration of say 0.4 seconds, and we want the action to ease in, and we'll do it after a delay of 0.4 seconds. So let's just save that. Now when the action takes place, it's not that jittery, and the image loads after the action. The panels are working as expected, and it's just beautiful to see. So this is just an example, and I hope it was useful for you in some way. And we can create such widgets in for different other application as well. So it was a learning experience for me as well in doing this. So yeah, thank you for watching, and see you guys in the next one.